H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
All right, so let's get started. Before that, I just wanted to know whether I'm audible and you're able to see my screen. Yes, all right. All right, so let's get started with the database testing introductory session. So we'll be starting off with the regular classes in a couple of days. So this is the introductory session on what is database testing and how do we go about doing database testing. So a very high level overview on this session to get you acquainted with the terminology of database testing, and we'll take it from there. Okay, so for all of you who have joined in now, what do you know about database testing? Can you tell me what is meant by database testing? What is database testing? Checking the tables, whether they are getting populated, getting updated properly or not. Testing of application behavior with different combination of data inputs. Yes, very close. Writing queries to test data in the database. So you're going into actual execution part, all right? And in database, you test tables, records using SQL queries. So again, you went into the application part, right? So like checking the database tables using SQL queries and whether the tables are getting updated properly or not, writing the queries to test data, these all come when you start executing your test cases, because database testing, or for that matter, any testing involves test cases, right? So when you start execution of those test cases, then these things come in. But first and foremost, why do we go about doing database testing? Let's understand that first. Okay. So when you log into any website, right? For example, let's say, let me just share my screen. Okay, let's say I'm onto this Amazon website. When you log into any website, you're getting deals and promotions, right? Now, I just logged into the homepage. It's showing me a big banner called Cyber Monday, okay? Then there are bucket of products displayed here, right? Devices, automobile, baby, beauty, books, whatever, right? So these are different product categories. I can't see your screen. Is my screen not shared? Let me just check. I think I'm sharing my screen. Is it not visible to all? Can't see. All right, let me share again. Stop and reshare. It's visible, okay. Many of you pinged it's visible, but still I'll just share it again. Yeah. Just let me know. Okay, I think it's visible now. So, database testing is all about maintaining sync with, or maintaining synchronization with, whatever is there on the front end. Okay, you see this Amazon website, you have departments, right? Or the product categories on the left-hand panel, right? Then there are something like you can sort by price, discount, all these features, right? And then there are a lot of other features like what are the deal coming up, or what are the like price ranges, discounts, average customer reviews. So I'm just going to the home page. So you can see there are different options coming on the home page. Now, if I take the same example and let's say you want to do these five activities on Amazon website. Okay. Like, let's say you want to put a filter on apparels. You want to select some clothes and want to put a filter on something like shirts or whatever, you want to put a filter on apparels. Okay, then you select that product, right? You make the payment. Once the payment is confirmed, then you get the status of your shipment, right? These are the five generally steps which you follow once you, when you want to order your product, isn't it or not? Or am I missing anything? Let's say you're into this website, you'll search like what you want, right? Like, let's say clothes. And herein, whatever filters you want to put in, you put in the filter. So as soon as I clicked on clothes, what happened at the back end? So this is something which is our area of concern or our area of work as a database tester. As soon as I clicked on clothes, what happens at the back end? A query runs. Okay, something like this. Select star from the there will be a table, product table, for example, where product category equal to clothes or apparels. This query will run at the back end and it will display on the front end these options. Okay, now among these options, let's say you again want to put some filter, there will be filter, I'm not getting it right away. So there will be a filter where you could just, let's say you just want to filter on shirts or something. Jeans or whatever it is, right? You can again put a filter on that, right? So you, somebody will get an option, I'm not getting it right away, somebody will get an option and you can filter out on those things, right? Now as soon as you click and put a filter, what happens at the back end? Again a query runs and it says that select start from product where product category is apparel and product sub category equal to jeans. That kind of a query runs in. So at a very, very high level, you as a database tester will be required to validate that whenever at the front end or in your website, somebody does any activity, is it getting properly reflected in your database tables or not? So when I clicked, when I selected apparels and when I selected jeans, am I getting only jeans or am I getting something else? Right, that is completely dependent on what output I'm getting from this query. Select start from product where product category equals to apparels and product subcategory equal to jeans. When as a database tester, you do a backend testing, you check for this scenario that, okay, when a user or when I select the product category as apparel and product subcategory as jeans, I should not get any other product. I should only get clothes, jeans. That is something which you need to validate at the back end first. If your data in the table is proper, then it will reflect properly in your front end also. So database testers are predominantly concerned with applications. Like we will be mostly concerned with application projects. All right. So application projects are what? They are a project which are used, like which are developed using technologies like Java, .NET, Python, Perl, and they are used to build applications or user interfaces which helps us to perform tasks easily, right? You have a Amazon website or you have a ticket reservation portal like booking.com or you have your net banking systems, right? All of these UIs help us to perform tasks easily, right? So whether the functionality of these UIs are working properly or not, that testing those is the job of a database tester. So you need to ensure that whatever data is displayed on the front end is correct or not. Okay, and how can that be ensured? That can only be ensured when the data in your backend underlying tables are correct. So as many of you rightly said, our job will be to test the data at the back end. But why? Because to ensure that whatever is there in the front end is accurate or not. Okay, so once you have put a filter on the product, right, then you will add the product to the cart, correct? Which means you will insert the record into some table. Okay, those table details anyway, when you start working on project, we'll get the details. So when you add a product, let's say I selected something and I add it to the cart, right? As soon as I click on this add to cart, right, a record needs to be inserted into the any table. So again, our job as an ETL tester would be to ensure whether as soon as the add to cart is done, whether something like, okay, before that, see, it's not allowing me to add to cart. So again, there is a rule which is being set. There is a stored procedure, something which is written that as soon until unless I select a size, right, it will not allow me to add to the cart. So once it's a prerequisite. So what happens when I clicked on add to cart, again, I can select different products. That anyway, I'm not giving you the details of the Amazon's website because you guys know it. What I'm trying to say here is, as soon as you click on add to cart, a record gets inserted into a database, something like this. Okay, insert into table based upon my customer ID, the data will be added, means inserted into the record. So here, we as a database tester will be required to see that whether the records are getting inserted properly or not, whether the inserts are happening properly or not. As soon as a customer adds a inserts a data, whether the inserts are happening properly or not, right? So once the product is added to the cart, then as soon as you add to the cart and make the payment, the billing table is, there is a separate table called as billing table. We'll be discussing about these data models and all when we get started with the regular sessions, but for example, for now, you'll have a billing table which will be invoked as soon as you add to the cart and click on purchase product. Okay, now once your payment is confirmed, another table gets invoked, which is a shipment table, which will track your all the shipment details. So what is happening? There's a chain of reaction. You first select the products, right? Then a record is inserted. Now a billing table gets invoked, right? And once the billing is confirmed, a shipment table gets involved. So whether this chain of events, is it working properly or not? Is all the database tables are getting triggered accordingly as per expectation or not? Validating all these will be the job of a database tester. Okay, so essentially at a very high level, your job as a database tester would be to ensure that whatever options the user is clicking here should give him accurate results. At a very high level, this will be your responsibility as a database tester. How do you fulfill this responsibility? By thoroughly testing all your underlying tables. And whatever many of you rightly said, that we'll have to do it through SQL query by looking at the tables, you're exactly correct. But why we do it? It is to ensure that the front end works properly. Okay, so this is on a very high level what is meant by database testing. We'll go into the intricacies of it as and when we get started. And like if you want to go through the course curriculum, whatever we have, you can browse to our website on database testing. So with the glimpse on what I had given about database testing, well, the first thing what you need to know is database concepts, right? What a database tester is supposed to know from a database standpoint. And then we'll quickly move to SQL queries, because SQL queries is something very important when it comes to database testing. There will be different scenarios, there will be different functionalities in a application. So different type of SQL queries might be required to validate those. So you need to know SQL from basic to intermediate till advanced level of SQL. So we'll be devoting a majority of time on module 2 and module 3, learning about the basic and the intermediate to advanced SQL. And finally, I talked about triggers, right? As soon as your billing is done, your shipment table gets invoked and all, right? So testing the triggers, trigger test, testing update triggers, insert triggers, delete triggers, all these we'll be discussing as part of our module 4. So you can go through this course syllabus on the H2K homepage. Just you need to go to the courses and you'll get it. But yeah, our focus would be predominantly on the database concepts, SQL queries, and corresponding objects which are used in SQLs. Okay, No. So there's a question. Do we need to test both parallel, I mean, on website front end and database table? No. As a database tester, you're just required to test in the back end. I'll be coming to it in a while. I have a few slides which I want to discuss. There you'll get the answer more elaborately. Just give me some time. In case your question is not answered, you can just ask me again. But yeah, to answer, no. Both will not be done by parallel. There's a separate team who does. So I wanted to take this slide later, but since you asked this question, let me take it up first. Okay. So there's a difference between user interface testing and database or data testing. Okay. So there's a question which came up now from Nirali is that do we need to test both in parallel? So database testers, as you can see on your screen, we are concerned with only backend testing. Okay, there's another team who obviously both these two work in tandem, but there will be a separate team who will be doing a UI testing. So whether the when you log into a website, right, whether when you give a username, there will be set of rules that it should start with alphabets or it should not start with special characters and all those things. So all the functionality of the website, okay, whether the images are getting displayed properly or not, whether when a filter is applied, okay, data should come properly. But let's say if you have applied this filter, okay, some filter you have applied, it should not take you to the, after this proceed to checkout, you go, need to go to the billing page, right? It should not take you back to the products page. So the function, there will be a lot of functionalities on a website, right? So checking the functionality is the job of a UI tester. So if you can see, this type of testing is also known as graphical user testing or front-end testing, okay? But what we are doing will be a back-end testing or database testing. And this type of testing chiefly deals with all the testable items that are open to the user for viewership and interaction, right? So this answers your question, the second part. The UI testing is concerned with whatever is there on the front end, whether the filters are coming properly or not, whether everything is working properly or not, this will be taken care by the UI testers. But if you apply, if let's say user applies a filter, okay, and instead of getting only product as clothes, he's getting other products also. Okay, so who will find out this issue? This issue will be found out by UI testers, right? Because they'll be testing at the front end, right? So first they will try to troubleshoot it from their end. If like it's an issue with the front end, they will take care of it. But if it is an issue at the back end, it will come to us. Once the application is launched, but when the application, when the Amazon website was in the development phase, everybody will be doing like the database testers and everybody would have tested it. It was all working fine. But let's say the app is up and running and some issue came in that when you're selecting a product, it is not showing up the that particular product, but it is showing a variety of other products as well. So in that case, who will be the first point of contact? It will be the UI testers. They need to troubleshoot why this came in. Okay, if it is an issue with their UIs, that needs to be sorted out. But if they confirm that no, it's an issue at the like there's no issue at the front end, then it comes to the database test. They need to then find out that okay, at the underlying table there are some issues, or maybe some table is getting logged, or there could be a variety of reasons. Okay, because of the issue at the database, like at the back end or the database, this issue is coming up. So then you need to resolve it. So to answer your question again, both doesn't work in parallel. There will be a separate team for UI testing and there will be a separate team for database testing. But when the application is supposed to be is in the development phase or the testing phase, there needs to be proper coordination between the UI testers and the database testers so that the app goes in without any issues in the production environment. Okay, so these are the roles and responsibilities of a UI tester, that they will be chiefly dealing with all the testable items that are open to users for viewership and interactions like forms, presentation, graphs, reports, etc. And then our job as a database tester would be to test all the items which are generally hidden from the viewership. Okay, these include internal process and storage like assembly, DBMS, like predominantly what you can understand is the database and the SQL, like databases like Oracle, SQL Server, MySQL, and all those. All right. And the items, for example, could be text boxes, whether when you select a particular text box, does it behave as expected or not, drop downs, images are displayed properly or not, look and feel of the overall application. These all are taken care of by the UI testers. But we, as database testers, will be concerned with checking whether the tables are getting properly populated properly or not, columns, stored procedures, triggers, all these are working properly or not. Okay, so this is what a database tester is supposed to know. And finally, the prerequisite for a UI tester is that they must have knowledge about the business requirement or the functionality of that application. But a database tester is supposed to know SQL concepts, like the database concepts and the SQL language. This is what the prerequisite of a database tester is. Like to get started or to work in a database testing project, you need to be acquainted or skilled enough in database concepts as well as SQL concepts. That's where our course is aligned here to deal predominantly with SQLs and the database concepts. That's where we will be focusing completely. Okay. Yeah. And there's one more slide which I wanted to get started up before going to the UI and the database testing differences, but since the question was asked, so I just jumped to that slide. But again, these are the three things which we should generally know when we start off with any testing: what, why, and how, right? So what is database testing? By now, with whatever examples or explanations I had given till now, you might have got to know that database testing is what, like, you check the tables, whether the triggers are working properly or not. When you click on billing, right, you should do the billing and go to shipment, right? So whether that is happening or not, that is called triggers. Okay, it is called triggers here. So whether the triggers are happening properly or not, it may involve creating complex queries to load. Yeah, there is one more important thing: load testing or stress testing. Okay, there might be periods, or like just like the recently concluded Black Friday, there might be periods where there'll be surge in sale, correct? So is our database capable of handling that surge in sales or not? Okay, let's say every day on an average, you're getting, let's say 10,000 transactions on an average. On a given day, if it becomes 1 million transactions, is your database capable enough to handle all those transactions or not? This is done using stress testing. There's a concept of stress testing where we check for the, when you apply a maximum load on the website or on the database, how does it respond? Okay, that's what is called as load or stress test the database and check its responsiveness. Okay, that is another important part in database testing. How does a database respond when subjected to stress? Okay, and then it checks for data integrity and consistency. Consistency means your product cost should not change frequently, right? It can change in a day or it can change in 3 to 4 hours. But let's say I clicked on a product now and I clicked after 5 minutes, it should not change that much, right? So data consistency and data integrity means data integrity, consistency, all these are database concepts. I'll talk in detail when we start off with the regular sessions. But yeah, data integrity and consistency, another important concept in database testing. So load testing, integrity, and consistency, along with checking various scenarios using SQL queries, is what we generally do in database testing. Okay, schema is nothing but a database structure, a table structure. For example, you have an employee table, right? You have employee ID, employee name, and salary, for example. Okay, so if somebody asks you, what is the schema of your table? So the schema is that it has three columns, and these three columns are employee ID, employee name, and salary. So the structure of any table is called a schema. Yeah, so integrity is a bigger topic, and I'll park it for now. And once we get started and we talk about database concept, the very first module, we'll discuss in detail what is data integrity. But for a high level, as of now, let's say you have a product table, okay, wherein some products are there, and you have a amount table where the cost of each product is mentioned. They should be properly integrated. There should be related means. Let's say a shirt is for, let's say, $20. In the product table, it like you have a shirt product column, and then when you go into the amount column, it should relate to 20. It should not go and relate to 200. So it is a bigger topic and a detailed one, and it needs more than 45 minutes to 1 hour to discuss in detail about data integrity. So I'll discuss it in the detail. For a high level, it is just to establish sync between different tables in a database. That is what is called as data integrity, to establish sync between different tables. All right, so these are the things which we do in database testing. Now, why is database testing done? So by now you might have understood that to ensure correctness of data, as exactly the same data that is in the database is retrieved by the web or the desktop application or the front-end application. So database testing is done to ensure that whatever data goes into the front-end is accurate. That's a one-liner, right? And how is database testing done? So as in any other testing activity, we will set up a test environment. Okay, the project team sets up a test environment, and then you'll run the test and finally validate the results. Okay, so we set up the test environment, we prepare our test cases, and then that is called as test case generation phase. And then finally, you execute your test cases, which is a test case execution phase. Okay, so this is the reason. What is database testing? Why is database testing done? And how is database testing done? So since there's a question on data integrity, I'll just give you one scenario here. Not going into very much detail, but I'll just give you one more scenario on the integrity part. For example, take this scenario. Okay, now, we have a customer feature table, okay, which has like a customer ID, address, and features which he has enrolled to. And then there is a billing table. There are two tables here. Now, customer has added, like, selected few products, added that to his cart, and then finally, what he wants to do is, just give me a moment. Just a moment. Okay, so if you look at this slide, we have a customer feature table, which has customer ID, address, and features, and then there is a billing table. Okay, so a customer selected few products, all right, then he added to the cart, and he wants a like name of the feature to which the customer wishes to subscribe. All right, he wants to go for a one-day delivery, for example. Can't see the slide. Is it like not visible to anybody? On the test scenario slide, is it not visible? It's visible, right? Malika, maybe you can see from your end some issue. You can close the window and log in. I think it's visible to others. All right, so Where was I? A customer selected few products, okay, and prior to billing, what he's doing is that he's selected a feature that he wanted a one-day delivery. Okay. Thereafter, what happens? These are all integrated, and we call this sequence of events as clubbed together can be termed as data integrity. Okay. So customer selected products, and then he went for a one-day delivery. He selected a feature that, yes, I want a one-day delivery. So what happens at the back end as soon as he selects a one-day delivery? Internally, when the one-day delivery option is selected, a query runs at the back end. Okay. Based upon the address provided, it will search whether one-day delivery is available in your area or not. Okay, if it is unavailable, it will show on your screen that it is not available. Okay, now if it is available, if the one-day delivery is available in your area, then it will check whether the customer is an Amazon Prime customer, because if he's an Amazon Prime customer, then only he'll get a one-day delivery, or he need to pay some additional amount of money to seek one-day delivery, right? So if the feature is available but incompatible with existing feature, means he's not an Amazon Prime customer, or he has not yet given a additional amount. So if feature is available, which means one-day delivery is available in your area, and he's an Amazon Prime customer, or he has given additional amount, then what happens? Your customer's feature record and your billing table is updated accordingly. See, so based upon all the checks which are done here, your billing table and accordingly one shipment table will be updated accordingly. So what we are trying to do is we are trying to maintain that data integrity, or we are trying to integrate the data from different tables. We just got the information from the customer that he wants to go for a one-day delivery, but checking all these features, whether it is available in the area or not, whether it's an Amazon Prime customer or not, after doing all those due diligence and after doing all those checks, your billing and your shipment tables get updated. So what we are trying to do, we are trying to maintain the data integrity between different tables, between the customer billing and the shipment table. All tables needs to be in sync. Be it any business scenario, all tables should be in sync for the business to work properly, right? So that is what is meant by data integrity. Data integrity needs to be upheld in all the tables. Okay, so this is on a high level what is data integrity. Okay, but yeah, we'll be discussing a lot around data integrity once we get started with this session. So this is what I had planned to, like, I don't want it, since this being a new topic, I didn't want to discuss too much about into the details about database testing and getting into too much technicalities as of now. But yeah, this is on a high level what is database testing. It's more to maintain the sync between your front end and the back end to ensure that whatever is there in the front end works properly, and that can only be done when your back end is working properly, right? And in back end, obviously all your data will be in tables, so you need to be proficient enough on database concepts as well as SQL queries, which will be the focus of our sessions. Okay, and this session will be around 20-25 hours of session, which will be scattered around 3 to 4 weeks. Okay, and the timing will be, I think, 9 p.m. EST something. I'm not sure about the timing, but this is what it is. Okay, so this is what I had for a small demo on what is going to come up for database testing. So any questions? So I think 8 p.m. or 9, this is what time? This is 8 p.m., right? So yes, 8 p.m. only. Yeah. will be on 8 p.m. EST. Okay, so predominantly with the lot of e-commerce website and the UIs coming in, maybe for the mobile apps, right? Even if you have mobile apps, they store data on their databases. So with the increasing number of mobile apps coming on the market, database testing like requirements have grown multifold over the past few years. I have more than 12.5 years of experience, and I have been seeing continuously like the demand for the database testers keeps on growing. It's purely because we have the every now and then, every week you get new apps get launched. Okay, so an app gets launched, which means that there is a database at the back end, and if there's a database at the back end, that needs to be tested, right? So database testers demand from a jobs prospect will always be there. Yes, so for any testing, specifically for database testing, or for any testing for that matter, right, Sujata? So you'll have to prepare your test cases first, and thereafter you go for test case execution. So there will be two phases, test case preparation and test case execution. In your test case preparation phase, you will jot down all your test scenarios, what you'll be testing. And thereafter, in your test case execution phase, you will actually test those scenarios in a QA environment. Yes, so this session will be every day, Monday to Friday, and based upon the availability of everybody, it can also I can also stretch on the weekends also. But again, Monday to Friday is confirmed. Weekend will be based upon everybody's availability and willingness to attend the weekend session. Yes, it will be 8 p.m. EST. So as QA, do we need to write complex queries is the question, right? So it all depends upon what scenarios you need to test. Your scenarios could be very simple, like just selecting from a table. So you do a select start from the table, or it could be very complex. And you get to know about the complexity when you get into a project, right? Your project could be simple. Can be medium complex. It could be complex. So, but we need to be prepared, right? Because for interview standpoint, I can prepare you with like 20 questions or 20 scenarios, which we'll be doing hands-on, because for every model, there will be a lot of hands-on exercise which we'll be doing, many projects which we'll be doing. So that will make you interview ready and the project ready, right? But when you get into a project, you never know, the project will be simple or complex. So the best option is to be prepared for the worst, right? So this course, you will be learning, starting off with the basic of SQL for the people who don't know anything about SQL. So we'll start off from the basics, we'll go to the intermediate, and then we'll also discuss in detail about complex SQL queries so that you are well prepared for any project which comes your way. Yeah, so recorded videos, whatever live sessions we'll have, we'll record the videos, we'll share that. Along with that, I'll be sharing the materials also and the installers. Like predominantly, we'll be needing a like Oracle or a SQL Server where we can fire SQL queries and practice multiple scenario sessions. So that will be shared by me if you don't have. The course would be of approximately 4 weeks, Kamalika. Oracle DB is same as SQL DB. Oracle is name of a database, SQL is name of a concept. So I'm not sure. SQL Server, if you're talking about, no, the databases are different, right? So Oracle is a separate database, SQL Server is a separate database. So any database where we can fire SQL queries should be good enough. Here we'll install Oracle and we'll learn. Oh, okay, SQL Management Studio. So SQL Management Studio just to fire queries in SQL Server, right? So if you have that, good, or else to have sync, I'll tell everybody to install Oracle so that everybody works on the same database. But it's good if you have any SQL Management Studio where you can fire SQL queries in MS SQL. There is a slight difference between syntax in different databases, Oracle, SQL Server, MySQL, Teradata, but essentially the concepts remain the same. So let's take one database and we'll get started, and that will be Oracle. Yes, Bhavya, so we have that session. Okay. So if you're interested to pursue a career on database testing, go for it. You will certainly be benefited, and from a job prospect also, because obviously, to be honest, we are undergoing these trainings to seek a job, right? And as I said, because of the growing number of applications, and be it mobile or the web applications, the demand for the database testers have been growing over the years. You can browse to the Gartner's website, the authorized ones, right? And you can see that data yourself. So once you are well equipped, the only place where I've seen people faltering, because I'm also part of my firm's recruitment panel, they'll have a sound database concept, but the only part where they generally falter is at the SQL queries. Okay, so that's where my aim here is. We'll be just having first module, which will be theoretical on database concept, but remaining all the modules, you can browse our website for the course syllabus. It'll all be SQL queries and completely scenario based. Yes, so you'll be getting all the recorded videos. Yeah, on the commercial part, whether you need to pay extra or what is the payment, you can drop me a note. I can connect you with the concerned authorities, or you can drop a note to training at the rate h2k infosys, whatever their website is, right? You can from a course related standpoint, you can ask me the questions, but if you're asking anything regarding the course fee, I can you can drop me a note on this email ID listing, and I can forward it to the H2K training team, who can get back, or else if you can directly talk with them, that's also okay. I just sent my email ID. Yes, so as of this month, Praveena, for December, we have the database testing plan and the basic ETL testing, and thereafter we'll be going for the advanced in the next month. Or maybe after the basics are over. Okay. So again, this will be a question which can go to the H2K team. For now, we have the database testing. All right. Okay, guys. So any other questions before we wind up? If not, then thank you. Hope to see you in the regular sessions soon. And yes, thank you. Thank you all.